Welcome to all. I am Dr. Sarita. Today we will discuss construction of balanced incomplete block designs using mutually orthogonal Latin squares. We know that for the statistical analysis and enhancing the precision of estimates, three basic principles, that is randomization, replication and local control, are being used in design of experiments. We know that if the experimental material is homogeneous, and the most simplest design in this situation, we can use completely randomized design. But if the experimental material is not homogeneous and fertility gradient is only in one direction, in that case, randomized block design is used by grouping the relatively homogeneous strata perpendicular to the fertility gradient. Similarly, here we will discuss construction of balanced incomplete block designs using mutually orthogonal Latin square. So, what is Latin square? Latin square designs are normally used in experiments to remove the heterogeneity of experimental material in two directions. Latin square is an arrangement of S symbols in S square cells such that each row and each column contains each symbol exactly once. We can see if we have S is equal to 3, then Latin square order is 3 cross 3. An arrangement of Latin square is S. Here we can see from the example, if we have three treatments and we symbolize first treatment as A, second treatment as B and third treatment is C, then we can see all the treatments should be occupied in each row and in each column. But repetition is not allowed in either row or either in column, means every symbol should be occur in either row wise or column wise exactly once time. Latin square requires that the number of replications should be equal to the number of treatments. We have two forms of Latin square, either Latin square is in standard form or either is in semi-standard form. What is standard form? Standard form means when we arrange a Latin square, here we can see S is equal to 3, so we have a Latin square of order S is equal to 3 cross 3 order. Here we can see in the first row, if we symbolize first treatment as A, second treatment as B and third treatment as C, then the three treatments appear in natural order in row wise, and these three treatments A, B and C appears in natural order in column wise, means the first row and the first column should be in natural order, then it is known as a standard form. Then what is semi-standard form? A Latin square is said to be in semi-standard form if the symbols or letters in the first row or first column appear in natural order. Means when we see the first Latin square, here treatment number A, B, C, these three treatments appears in natural order in the first row, but treatment A, C and B, these three treatments are not in natural order in column wise. Similarly, if we see second example, here treatment number A, treatment number C, treatment number B, these three treatments are not occur in natural order, but when we see column wise, treatment number A, treatment number B and treatment number C appears in natural order. So means the difference between standard form and in semi-standard form means treatments appears in natural order in row wise and in column wise, then it is known as standard form. But when these three treatments either occur in natural order in row wise or in column wise, then it is known as a semi-standard form. Similarly, our objective is construction of BIBD using orthogonal Latin square. What is orthogonal Latin square? Orthogonal Latin square means if we have same order of Latin squares and after superimposing of Latin squares on one another, and then we can check no pair of symbols is repeated in the Latin square. If we denote the symbols of first Latin square by Latin letters and the symbol of second Latin square by Greek letters, and then we superimpose of these two Latin square on one another, we can see this is our the resulted Latin square. In this Latin square, if we can check treatment number A into alpha. This pair is not repeated anywhere in the whole Latin square, means every pair occur once, exactly once time. You can check any other treatment. A beta. A beta is occur only in this cell. No, this treatment is repeated in anywhere in the whole design. Means after superimposing of Latin squares, no pair of treatments occurs more than once. Means every ordered pair appears exactly once, then it is known as orthogonal Latin square. Now we have mutually orthogonal Latin square. Our question is, if we have a Latin square of order S, then what is the total number of moles of order S we can construct from that Latin square? So if we have a set of Latin squares and every pair of these Latin square is orthogonal, then the total number of mutually orthogonal Latin square of order S is at most S minus 1. Means if you have S is equal to 3, then the total number of mutually orthogonal Latin square of order S can be constructed at most 2. If you have S is equal to 2 raised to the power 2 is equal to 4, then the total number of moles of order S means S is equal to 4 is at most 3. Now we can construct Latin square so that every entries in row wise or in column wise is distinct. So we construct the Latin square of order S using the elements of Galois field S. Here we discuss the construction of Latin square. Either S is a prime number or either S is a prime power. If you have S is a prime number, then the elements of Galois fields are 0, 1, 2 up to S minus 1. Remember that the row and column numbers in the first Latin square are kept in natural order, in row wise and in column wise. And then the contents of first Latin square are obtained by adding the corresponding entries of row and column with made S. Means all the elements should be distinct in the row wise and in the column wise. The contents of second Latin square are then obtained by adding the corresponding entries of row and column with mod S. Therefore, a complete set of mutually orthogonal Latin square is obtained when V is equal to S, means it is a prime number. Similarly, here if we have S is equal to prime number or S is a prime number, we can construct Latin square using this method. Here, if we know that alpha is a primitive element of Galois field S, then we take the elements of Galois field S, means alpha naught is equal to 0, alpha 1 is equal to 1, alpha 2 is equal to x, alpha s minus 1 is equal to x raised to the power s minus 2. Remember that x raised to the power s minus 1 is always is equal to 1. Let us construct the Latin square Li whose rth position is filled by the element. We use this equation for constructing the first Latin square. Remember that here the notation R, I and T is used. R means number of rows, T means number of columns and I means order of the Latin square. Remember that Latin square started from number 1 and row number and column number started from 0. 0 means 0th row, first row and S minus 1th row. When L1 is constructing by cyclically permuting the columns, the other Latin square which are mutually orthogonal can be constructed from the first Latin square. Here we will discuss the construction of the Latin square by when S is a prime power. We illustrate this with the help of example. For example, if we have S is equal to 2 raised to the power 2 is equal to 4, means that is a prime power, and alpha means is a primitive element of the Galois field of S. तो इफ x इज ए प्रिमिटिव एलिमेंट देन द गैलोइस फील्ड ऑफ 2 रेज द पावर 2 आर अल्फा नॉट इज इक्वल टू 0, अल्फा 1 इज इक्वल टू 1, अल्फा 2 इज इक्वल टू x, अल्फा 3 इज इक्वल टू x स्क्वायर. हियर x स्क्वायर बिकम्स x प्लस 1 यूजिंग द मिनिमल फंक्शन x स्क्वायर प्लस x प्लस 1 इज इक्वल टू 0. So we start construction of Latin square using the equation alpha r plus alpha I into alpha t. Remember that when we construct first Latin square, the zeroth row and the zeroth column should be in natural order, and then the remaining elements can be filled by the equation alpha r plus alpha I into alpha t. For example, if we want to fill this cell, one, this is the first row and the second column. So here r is equal to 1 and t is equal to 2 and I is equal to 1. So if we put these values in this equation, r is equal to 1. Here row number is 1. Alpha 1, alpha 1 is equal to 1 plus alpha 1. Alpha 1 means here first Latin square value, I is equal to 1. Alpha t, t means second column here, and alpha 2 is equal to x. By putting these values in this equation, we get the value 1 plus x. Similarly, all the other elements can be obtained using the equation alpha r plus alpha I into alpha t. Remember that the first row, zeroth row and the zeroth column should be in natural form in the first Latin square. After constructing the first Latin square, the other Latin square can be obtained by cyclically permuting the columns. We can see zeroth column should be in the natural form. Here, the first column of the previous Latin square becomes the last column of the next Latin square. And then the other columns should be cyclically permuting. Means this is the second column. This second column becomes the first column and the third column becomes the second column. After constructing the Latin square, when we superimpose L1, L2 on L1, all the pairs should be occur only once time. Then here S is equal to 4. Then the total number of moles of S is equal to 4 becomes 3. Then the third Latin square can be obtained from the second Latin square after cyclically permuting. In this, zeroth column will be same in the third Latin square and the first column of the second Latin square becomes the last column of the next Latin square, and the second column becomes the first column, and the third column becomes the last column of the third Latin square. Here we can see we obtained 3 Latin square, and we can check after superimposing of 3 Latin square every pair occurs exactly once. Means all the Latin square constitute a complete set of mutually orthogonal Latin square. We know that here S is equal to 4. Latin square requires that the number of replications equal to the number of treatments. But if we have a large number of treatments, for example, here S is equal to 7, then treatment number becomes 49. So in that case, it is not possible all the 49 treatments in a single block, because the homogeneity of material, maintenance of homogeneity of material becomes a problem and calculation may be cumbersome. So in that case, we can use incomplete block designs, and from the incomplete block designs, here we discuss construction of balanced incomplete block designs. Now, what is BIBD? Balanced incomplete block design is an arrangement of V treatments in B blocks of K plots, such as each treatment occurs once and only once in R blocks, and each pair of treatments occur together in lambda means. Lambda blocks means V, B, R, K and lambda are known as the parameters of the BIBD. What is V? V is the number of treatments, K is the size of the block, B is the number of blocks, R is the repetition of the treatment. Lambda means pair of treatments occur together in blocks. Parameters are not independent, but they are interact. These are known as parameters because design is based on the value of these parameters. If we change the value of the parameters, the design will be changed. Here we discuss two orthogonal series, which is known as from BIBD. The first series is with parameters V is equal to S square, B is equal to S into S plus 1, R is equal to S plus 1, K is equal to S, and lambda is equal to 1. And another orthogonal series is V is equal to B is equal to S square plus S plus 1, and R is equal to K is equal to S plus 1, and lambda is equal to 1. In the second series, we can see V is equal to B, means number of treatments is equal to number of blocks, and size of the block is equal to the number of replications. If this equality holds, the design is known as symmetrical design. Here we will discuss construction of BIBD using models introduced by Aids in 1936 with these parameters. So only first series we illustrate. So how can we construct BIBD using models? So after constructing the mutually orthogonal Latin square, firstly we can see here V is equal to S square. S is equal to 2 raised the power 2, means S is equal to 4, that is a prime power. Firstly, we arrange a form of an S cross S square array in natural order. If we have V is equal to 16, so firstly we numbered the treatments as 1, 2, 3 up to the 16, and then we form a S cross S square array in natural order. As we can see here, a natural array form is presented here. After that, when we construct first Latin square, we symbolize the first Latin square symbols as 0 is equal to A, 1 is equal to B, X is equal to C, and 1 plus X is equal to D in the first Latin square. After symbolize the treatments in the first Latin square, the Latin square denoted by L11 becomes A, B, C, D, and column wise we can see first column A, B, C, D, means this is a first Latin square. When we superimpose this Latin square on the array by superimposing L11 on S cross S square array, this second Latin square becomes 1A into 2B into 3C, 4D up to 16A. Means after constructing the first Latin square, then using the parameters of BIBD, we construct a square array of S cross S square array, and then superimpose this square array on the first Latin square. The resulted Latin square is this. Then similarly, by arranging the treatments symbolically in second Latin square and second Latin square superimpose on the square array, then the second Latin square becomes is S. Similarly, by arranging the third Latin square on the S cross S square array, we can get L23, which is a third Latin square. How can we use these Latin square to constructing a BIBD? We can use the first S blocks from the first Latin square and the next S blocks according to column wise from the first Latin square, and then S blocks can be constructed according to the treatment wise. We can see if we take first Latin square, so first block of the BIBD becomes 1, 2, 3 and 4. Second block becomes 5, 6, 7, 8. Third block becomes 9, 10, 11, 12. And fourth block becomes 13, 14, 15, 16, means here S is equal to 4. So four blocks can be constructed using row wise. Now if we take according to column wise, column number 1, 5, 9 and 13 constitute the fifth block. Similarly, treatment number 2, 6, 10 and 14 constitute the 6th block, and 3, 7, 11 and 15 constitute the 7th block, and 4, 8, 12 and 16 constitute the 8th block. Next, S blocks from the first Latin square can be constructed using the position of the treatments. We can see if the treatment number A occur at the in this cell, in the 6th cell, in the 11th position and in the 16th position. So, 9th cell can be constituted using the elements 1, 6, 11 and 16. Similarly, the next block can be constituted using the position of the treatment number B, and treatment number B occurs at 2nd place, 5th place, 12th place and 15th place. Similarly, all the blocks can be constructed using the position of different elements in different Latin scale. Here we can see the positions of treatment number C, and the next block can be constituted using the position of treatment number D. So here we constitute S blocks according to row wise, S blocks according to column wise and S blocks according to position of the treatment. Similarly, from the second Latin square, we can obtain the S blocks using the position of the treatments. So here treatment number A occur at 1st position and 8th position and 10th position and the 15th position. Similarly, taking the treatment number B, C and D, you can construct S blocks from this design. Similarly, from the third Latin square, using the position of treatment number A, B, C and D, S blocks can be constructed from this Latin square. When we obtain the blocks of from these Latin squares, so we have S into S plus 1 blocks from this Latin square. And this is the presentation of BIBD using the parameters V is equal to S square. S square is equal to 4 into 4, 16. B is equal to S into S plus 1 means 20. R is equal to S plus 1 means 5. K is equal to S means 4 and lambda is equal to 1. Lambda means each pair occurs exactly once in the blocks. Here we can see pair 1, 2 occur only in this block. Now this pair is repeated in either block in the whole design. And R is equal to 5 means replication. Treatment number 1 is repeated here, and then here, and then in this block, and in this block, and in this block. So we can see every treatment is repeated only 5 times. And number of blocks you can count, total number of blocks is equal to 20, and size 1, 2, 3, 4. Size of every block is equal to 4. So here we discuss the construction of balanced incomplete block design using mutually orthogonal Latin square when S is a prime power. Similarly, we can construct BIBD when S is a prime number. For example, S is equal to 5 using the equation alpha r plus alpha I into alpha t. Using this method, we can also construct the BIBD when S is a prime number. So this is the final presentation of the OS1 series when S is equal to 5. And similarly, we can construct BIBD for any value of S, either S is a prime number or either S is a prime power, using this method. For the further reading, you can take the help this book, Construction and Combinatorial Problems in Design of Experiment by D. Raghav Rao. I think I discuss all the terms used in construction of BIBD with the help of models. So, thank you very much.